You're watching Bully Badass TV, YouTube's best channel for dog lovers.
The Neapolitan Mastiff is one of the molosser type of dogs, which probably descend from the common stock. Whether this was the molosses attested to in antiquity is controversial. Despite centuries of popularity throughout Europe, this type of dog was almost lost after World War II. Soon after the war, Italian painter Piero Scanziani established a breeding kennel to turn the Mastiff-type dogs of Italy into a formal breed, which was then named the Neapolitan Mastiff. English Mastiff was used to help in the process. Neapolitan Mastiff is large and powerful. They are heavy animals, oftentimes exceeding 150 pounds. Their bodies are covered in loose skin with a coat that can be either black, blue, mahogany, or tawny. The Neapolitan Mastiff has a low activity level, even as a puppy. Visits to dog parks should be minimum, considering they can be dog aggressive. The ideal environment for this breed is a home with a large yard and fence 5 or 6 feet high. Even though the breed does not need a great deal of physical exercise, it requires plenty of space to live. One cannot expect the giant Neapolitan Mastiff to force itself into small living quarters. The breed is fond of outdoors but does not do well in warm weather. Just like other giant breeds, its veterinary, boarding, and food bills can be quite high. Obsessive house cleaners should also think twice before getting such a dog, as the breed often makes messes with its food and drink and tends to drool. The Neapolitan Mastiff is fearless and extremely protective of its home and family. They prefer to be with their family. The Neapolitan Mastiff rarely barks unless under provocation, renowned for sneaking up on intruders, as opposed to first alerting them of its presence. Neapolitan Mastiffs as a breed are extremely intelligent dogs with a tendency to be independent thinkers. They learn quickly, which is both good and bad, since this guardian breed needs extensive proper socialization to learn to accept strangers, especially within their home. Without proper early socialization and training, these dogs are likely to become aggressive towards strangers and unfamiliar dogs. The Neapolitan Mastiff is not a breed for most people and certainly not a dog for beginners. Neapolitan Mastiffs must be well socialized with people, especially children, as they are large, powerful dogs and do not always know their own strength. Additionally, young children have young friends, and even with extensive socialization and training, Neapolitans will be wary of strangers and protective of their family, which can be disastrous for small children. Most of the time, they will protect their owners with their lives. Additional protection training is unnecessary because they are natural guard dogs and always have been. As with every breed, obedience training is very important. The Neapolitan is very tolerant of pain due to the breed's early fighting background and the fact that the skin is so loose. So it is important to routinely check for health problems, as Neapolitans may not behave differently when injured or ill. The Neapolitan Mastiff, which has an average lifespan of 6 to 8 years, is susceptible to major health issues such as canine hip dysplasia and cardiomyopathy, and minor concerns like cherry eye and elbow dysplasia. To identify some of these issues early, a veterinarian may recommend hip, eye, elbow, and cardiac exams for this breed of dog. For many centuries, this breed was used as a family guardian, thus making the Neapolitan Mastiff a truly devoted, watchful, and loyal dog, which is wary of strangers and tolerant of familiar people. It loves to stay at home and show affection towards children, but its huge size can lead to accidents. The Neapolitan may not mix properly with other dogs, particularly the dominant types. However, this can be rectified if the dog is trained and socialized at a young age. Neapolitans are confident and can be a bit domineering, and therefore not recommended for inexperienced dog owners.